what we are considering as Planet 9 might actually be a black hole. This isn't just speculation, but something suggested by trusted sources such as Astronomy Magazine, the American Physical Society, the New York Times, Forbes, and many other agencies. But is this just a headline to attract people? Or is there some truth hidden in it? In today's video, I will try to answer the second most mysterious question of the century with data. So, hello guys, this is Brain Bargain, and let's start another new episode. Astronomy is gravity, and gravity is astronomy and astrophysics. If you look closely at astrophysics, you may not see any particular factor or phenomenon, but you will see gravity everywhere, from a tiny item to the largest black holes. Because of this gravity, in 1845, French astronomer Urbain Le Verrier pinpointed the location and existence of Neptune without any high-tech space telescopes, merely by observing gravitational anomalies in the orbit and performing mathematical calculations. In 1859, Le Verrier also noticed disturbances in Mercury's orbit and hypothesized the existence of a planet called Vulcan, which was believed to exist between the Sun and Mercury. However, the solution to this orbital anomaly was provided by Einstein's theory of relativity in 1915. From the beginning until now, whenever we have observed any gravitational anomaly, a breakthrough has always followed. And in the case of Planet 9 in our solar system, a strong gravitational anomaly is also observed, not in one or two, but in more than 200 objects. The first was seen in Sedna. Sedna, discovered in 2003, is a dwarf planet that was found in the solar system at that time. It changed everyone's perception about the outer solar system. While planets far away were generally imagined to be gray or white, Sedna appeared Mars-like red. But that wasn't the strangest part. The strange thing was that the dwarf planet's orbit was extremely elliptical, which is generally seen in objects within the Oort cloud. However, Sedna was located about 10 times farther than the inner edge of the Oort cloud. To explain this anomaly, the hypothesis was proposed that a passing star's gravity pulled Sedna out of the Oort cloud and towards the solar system, locking it gravitationally with the Sun. But we have no data on when this mysterious star might have come. Even if we assume that a passing star pushed 10 to 12 objects into such strange orbits, as the years passed and technology advanced, the number of anomalies increased. In a research paper published on April 18, 2024, when the latest data on the anomalies of trans-Neptunian objects was analyzed, two simulation graphs were presented. The first graph showed the orbits of objects that were more than 100 astronomical units away from the Sun, with orbits inclined at 10 to 36 degrees towards a specific object or a specific point. This indicated that something was forcefully influencing these objects against the gravity of the Sun. This data only included dwarf planets. On page 5 of the same research paper, there were two simulating plots. The first plot showed the object density scenario when Planet 9 exists, and the second showed the scenario when there is nothing like Planet 9. In real life, the object density beyond Neptune matched the data from the simulation supporting Planet 9's existence. By individually examining the positions, nothing clear could be deduced. So, scientists ran simulations of all these inclined orbits to find out which positions these objects follow and whether their orbital or solar positions ever intersect. Fortunately, they found something. The research found that at certain times, these objects seem to escape Planet 9's gravitational force and enter the Sun's gravitational dominance. When these scenarios were put into mathematical calculations, an interesting fact emerged. If these objects are influenced by a planet, its mass should be at least 5 to 10 times that of Earth, and its distance from the Sun should be about 400 to 1,500 astronomical units. Only then could it stay away from the Sun's gravitational dominance and manipulate the orbits of these objects. Now let's get back to solid basic calculations. We usually end the video after discussing calculations about Planet 9, but not this time. Because this time, regarding the orbital anomaly, scientists broadened their spectrum. Instead of treating Planet 9 as a confirmation, they treated it as a possibility, and we found two such alternatives that not only explain the gravitational anomaly but also provide answers to why we haven't found Planet 9. These alternatives offer a different perspective and lead us to a final conclusion. And now we are going to talk about them. To connect the dots here, we need an object with significant gravitational power. Now, it doesn't necessarily have to be a planet. the best candidate for gravity is obviously a black hole. According to calculations, the gravitational force that a planet the size of Planet 9 would have could also be possessed by a black hole of the same scale. If this black hole is the size of an orange, it would have the same gravitational power as Planet 9. Such small black holes generally don't form after a supernova but are known as primordial black holes, which came into existence fractions of a second after the Big Bang. These black holes are so small that being the size of an orange is a big deal for them. Sometimes they are even said to be as small as a hydrogen atom. Now, the next question would be, if these black holes came into existence right after the Big Bang, how are they present in our solar system? Very simple, because black holes, like stars, move around in the cosmos. This black hole could have moved into our solar system and be deceiving us. This explanation perfectly aligns with all our observations so far and answers why we haven't been able to find Planet 9 or any other object responsible for this anomaly, reason being that it's impossible to see such an object. Now, locating black holes is known to be difficult because not even light escapes from them. So, can we ever verify this hypothesis? The answer is yes, and the good news is that we might get confirmation very soon. Astrophysicists from Harvard, Avi Loeb and Amir Siraj have come up with a method to detect these black holes. They noticed that when objects in the Oort cloud, such as comets, move near black holes, a visible flare of light is created. If we observe continuous flares of light at any of the proposed locations of Planet 9, it would be direct proof of the existence of a black hole in that area. However, this search will take some time because this research will be conducted as part of the Legacy Survey of Space and Time, LSST, by the Rubin Observatory, which will last for 10 years. The survey will start in August 2025, meaning we will have to wait at least 1 to 2 years to get confirmation of this news. And if it turns out to be true, what could be better for us than knowing that we live so close to a black hole? The first explanation is done, but the second explanation is even more complex. It suggests that these gravitational anomalies are not anomalies at all. Instead, they are a concept of a physics topic that we do not yet understand. According to Sir Isaac Newton's second law, the force exerted on an object is inversely proportional to the distance between the object and the body that is pulling it. This means that the farther an object gets from something, the weaker the gravitational force it experiences from that object, and it moves towards the pulling object with less intensity. However, on September 22, 2023, Harsh Mather and Catherine Brown published a research paper in the Astronomical Journal. They examined all the orbital inconsistencies through the lens of a hypothetical gravity principle and found that all previously observed anomalies vanished. This hypothetical principle was named modified Newtonian dynamics. The problem was that when we were observing galaxies, we noticed many different things that didn't align with classical physics. According to classical physics, objects closer to the galactic center should move faster, those a bit farther should move slower, and those at the very edge of the galaxy should move at an ultra-slow speed around the galactic center. However, in real life, when data on the movement speeds of objects at the outer edges of the galaxy was analyzed, it was found that the measured orbital velocities of these objects were exactly opposite to their calculated orbital velocities. The galactic curve was measured in such a way that it seemed like the objects at the outer edges of the galaxy were defying gravity because their high orbital speed could only be justified in that case. Multiple observations convinced scientists that they were missing a piece of physics concerning gravity. To fix this missing piece, they recalled Mond's original theory, proposed by Milgram in 1983. This is a gravity model suggesting that Newton's gravity law is not universal. Newton's law states that at a particular distance, the gravitational pull between two objects weakens in proportion to the square of the distance between them. In other words, if the distance between two objects doubles, the gravitational pull between them becomes 4 times weaker. This law was thought to be universal, but after observing this galactic anomaly, the implementation of Mond was emphasized. According to Mond, beyond a certain distance, the gravitational pull becomes directly proportional to the distance. This means that the gravitational pull between two objects doesn't decrease as quickly as it does according to Newton's classical second law. Keeping this in mind, Dr. Mather suggested that these Kuiper Belt objects are not being pulled by a planet, but rather by the mass and gravity of our Milky Way galaxy, which attracts these objects. As a result, While the Sun's gravity causes their orbits to be elliptical within the solar system, the almost equal force applied by opposing forces causes their orbits to extend equally in the opposite direction. The technical research papers imply that the problem or anomaly isn't in their orbits, but rather in our conceptual understanding. However, it's not wrong to say that MOND is still a hypothetical prediction developed specifically to explain gravitational anomalies, rather than a proven concept. Whether there is a black hole or not, we will get an answer in about 2.5 years. And the proving of the MOND concept might also happen soon. But before we wrap up, here's a question for you. Besides Sedna, which other objects have these orbital anomalies been observed in? You can write your answer in the comments section below. If you like this video and learned something new about Planet 9, please like the video and share it with your friends.